Hello and welcome to this channel, which I call as Musings by Amit Patel. Today I'm going to talk about finding my first job. You know, finding your first job is usually difficult. I meet a lot of engineers and they ask me, how do we find our first job? I don't know whether I can help anyone to find a job based on all the different things that you need to do to be able to get a job. But I can tell you how I was able to find my very first job. In July of 1995, I completed my engineering from Pune University. After that, I started searching for a job. I was of the view that marks are not important. Knowledge is important. So my marks were very less. I got 55.95% in my final year of engineering. Over the rest of the 3 years of engineering, my marks were about 50%. They were average marks. Now, I had a very strong belief that marks are not important, and irrespective of what marks I get, I can easily find a job. Contrary to my beliefs, my parents as well as everybody around me were not so confident of this theory. They said, Amit, you're not going to get a decent job with the marks you have got. I ignored everyone. I started thinking positive, thinking that no matter what, I'm going to find a good job, irrespective of what my marks said about me. So I went and got a 3-page resume typed. In those days, there were no internet cafes. So the only way you could get your resume done was on a typewriter. So I got a 3-page resume typed. There were no job boards. So there was no monster.com. There was no naukri.com. There was no indeed.com. The only way of getting a job was one, either you look for an advertisement in the newspaper, or you have some reference, you apply through that reference. This was the only way of finding a job. So I started looking at the newspaper every day. If I found something which was close to my electronics engineering, I would send them the 3-page resume. This was done using a post. So you can imagine that after I send my resume, it would have taken something like 5 to 10 days for that resume to land on the right person's table. And after that, it depends whether he would reply back to me or put it in a dustbin. I never got a reply, which means all my resume went into a dustbin. After a month, my confidence was coming down, but my ego was very high. I was not ready to accept defeat. Marks are not important. I have to prove this point to everyone around me. I had a very brilliant idea. There is a place in Mumbai called SEEPS. It stands for Santa Cruz Electronics and Export Processing Zone. This was like IT zones nowadays or SEZs nowadays. This was a place where most of the electronics and computer companies were situated. There were more than 100 companies within this SEEPS. So I had a brilliant plan, and along with my friend, I said, let's go there and let's distribute our resume to every company in this place. Before going there, I just showed my resume to one of my uncle who was a general manager of Pidilite. He said, cut it down to 1-page resume. I got my resume cut down to 1 page. Then I got one resume, went to a Xerox machine and got 30 copies of my resume done. Same thing I did for a cover letter. Now I had 1-page cover letter and 1-page resume, and I bought 30 envelopes. I nicely tucked my resume and cover letter in each envelope, and along with my friend who did the same thing, we headed towards SEEPS. Now you don't get permission to go inside SEEPS because it's a export processing zone. We had a friend working in Putney Computers at that point of time, so we got him to get us a visitor's pass. So we went there in the morning at about 10 o'clock. We went inside SEEPS, and first thing we visited, handed over our resumes to our friend. Now our friend said, don't worry, I will give it to the HR. After that, we went about every company that we could find, which we felt that this is the company which would entertain us. We went there and started giving our resume. Now there are 3 ways in which we gave our resume. One was, there was a drop box outside each company. So we dropped our resume in most of this Dropbox. At the places where there were no Dropboxes, we handed over our resume to the security because the security would not allow us to go inside. And there were other companies which were closed by the time we reached their doors. We slid our resume under the doors, thinking that when somebody came in, he's going to pick up our resume, give it to the HR, and then the HR is going to give us a call. After spending the entire day at SIEPS and wasting all the 30 resumes, we went back home very satisfied that at least one or two companies are going to give us a call. Nothing of that sort happened. 1 week passed, 2 weeks passed, an entire month passed. Not a single company gave us a call. Now, my confidence was breaking down. I was on the verge of accepting defeat, but I did not know what to do. My ego kept fighting back and saying, Amit, don't worry, you are going to get a good job. One day I was walking close to my home and I saw a big banner of a computer institute called Data Pro, which said that learn C, C++ and Unix, get 100% placement in a computer industry. I just focused on 100% placement. I will get 100% placement by this institute and I will get a job. That was the thought that was going on in my mind. I came back home. I spoke to my dad. My dad had seen computers at his office. He was convinced that if I learned computers, the chances of me getting a job would be higher. So he was convinced. But the cost of the course was quite high. It was 9,000 rupees in those days, which was very high by those days standard. Anyways, my dad was okay to give me that money. And I went and I enrolled into C, C++ and Unix. The course was designed in such a way that there were 4 hours of lectures in a week, and 4 hours we had to go and practice in a computer lab. There were about 20 computers in the computer lab, and we had to book a computer and then practice at least 4 hours in a week. After we did that for 3 months and we passed the C, C++ and Unix exam, they would give us a certificate, and along with the certificate they would also give us 100% placement. Since I didn't have anything to do during that period of time, I started spending my time in the computer lab. The lab used to open at 9 o'clock in the morning and used to close down at 9 o'clock in the night. And I used to sit from 9 o'clock to 6 o'clock at the times when I did not have to attend the lecture. I used to spend the entire day in the lab. And because there were hardly any students who were visiting the lab, all the computers were unoccupied. After a few days, few of the students thought I was a lab instructor. They used to come and ask me questions on C and C++ when their programs were not working properly. So what I used to do is I used to help them debug their programs and make them working. It was a good learning experience because I was writing my own programs and I was also helping other people to write their programs. This happened for a period of about 1 month, after which the institute got the wind of someone sitting in the lab who acts like a lab instructor. The HR of the institute called me into a meeting and she asked me, Amit, why are you spending your entire day in the lab? And I told her that I don't have anything to do. I've finished my engineering. I'm looking for a job. At present, I don't have a job. So I'm spending all my time in the institute. So she told me that she can help me find a job just on the basis of my engineering degree. And I was very happy. That was the 100% placement that they had promised. And I thought that finally, I'm going to get a job. On the next day itself, she got an appointment for me with an antivirus software company called NashOt. Now, NashOt in those days was a very good antivirus software company. It had branches all over India. Of all the branches, there was one branch in Nariman Point which had about 6 to 7 marketing executives and 2 to 3 support engineers. At the time when they interviewed me, all the support engineers had left and they were looking for a support engineer to join their team. Now I gave the interview. The manager who was taking my interview asked me a lot of questions about antivirus and about how the hard disk in a computer works. I was not able to answer any of those questions. He also asked me a lot of general questions and he asked me a lot of questions related to technology. He asked me questions related to my project, which I was able to clearly answer. Now, the manager was in two minds and he gave me a proposal. He said, Amit, you are very good in communication. Why don't you join our marketing team? And I said, no, I'm not interested in marketing. I'm only interested in customer support. In my mind, I had this view that I wanted to be as technical as possible. In some way, I wanted to become a programmer, and that was the stepping stone. I thought that if I get a job as a customer support engineer for a software and I keep learning software development on the side, at some point I will be able to switch over to software development. The manager clearly told me that I did not know anything that was required by that particular support role. I needed knowledge about antivirus, and I needed some knowledge about how did the hard disk work for storing information. And I did not know any of these things. So I told the manager, you give me a chance, you give me 1 month, you give me whatever books you can to read, you show me whatever you can teach me on the job, and I will learn. After 1 month, if you still find that I am not capable, I am ready to leave this place. Now, he was very impressed by my attitude, as well as he was impressed by my honesty. So he said, okay, fine, I'm going to give you a chance for 1 month, and after 1 month we will evaluate where you are and decide whether you stay in this job or not. I joined that company next day. It did not take my manager more than 2 weeks to decide that he had to make me a permanent customer support engineer in that place. I stayed with that company for 18 months, and during that period, I learned everything which became the foundation of my career. So this is the story of how I was able to find my first job. The reason I'm telling you this story is, a lot of engineers, when they come out of their college, they think that because they do not have good marks, they cannot get a good job. Now, I would say that it is not just that your marks are responsible. Yes, they are responsible for giving you opportunities and giving you that boost to get into an interview. But irrespective of your marks, depending on your honesty and your attitude, you can get a really good job. So best of luck to everyone who's trying to find a job today, and try to think what are the things that you can do to find a good job. Thank you very much. Keep coming back for more, and subscribe to my channel, Musings by Amit Patel.